They are known for being pioneers in the field of electronic music. They are recognized for writing the first electronic music for magnetic tape composed in the United States. Their names are Bebe and Louis Barron. In the realm of electronic music, there are two names that stand out as pioneers, Bebe and Louis Barron. This American couple, born in the early 1920s, made groundbreaking contributions to the field that would forever shape the future of music. Bebe Barron, born on June 16, 1925, and Louis Barron, born on April 23, 1920, were true trailblazers in their time. They are widely recognized for their achievement in writing the first electronic music for magnetic tape in the United States. This groundbreaking composition opened up new possibilities and paved the way for the electronic music we know today. But their impact didn't stop there. The Barrons went on to make history once again by creating the first entirely electronic film score for the MGM movie Forbidden Planet. Released in 1956, this science fiction classic showcased the Barrons' innovative approach to music. Their unique soundscapes and experimental techniques captivated audiences and forever changed the way we experience film music. The significance of their compositions cannot be overstated. The Barrons' work not only pushed the boundaries of what was possible in music but also laid the foundation for future electronic musicians. Their pioneering efforts paved the way for the development of synthesizers and other electronic music instruments, revolutionizing the entire genre. Bebe and Louis Barron's contributions to electronic music are nothing short of legendary. Their groundbreaking compositions and innovative techniques continue to inspire musicians and shape the landscape of music. Their names will forever be synonymous with the birth of electronic music, and their legacy will live on in the annals of music history. In the early 1950s, Bebe and Louis Barron, the pioneering composers of electronic music, found themselves immersed in the avant-garde scene. However, they soon realized that this artistic movement did not bring them the financial success they desired. Turning their attention to Hollywood, they discovered that the film industry had already been incorporating electronic instruments like the theremin into soundtracks for several years. Collaborating with celebrated filmmakers, the Barrons began providing music and sound effects for art films and experimental cinema. One of their notable partnerships was with Ian Hugo, for whom they scored three short experimental films based on the writings of his wife, Anais Nin. Among these films, Bells of Atlantis and Jazz of Lights stood out as remarkable examples of their musical compositions. Additionally, the Barrons lent their expertise to Maya Deren in the audio production of the soundtrack for The Very Eye of Night, a film that featured music by Teiji Ito. They also contributed their talents to Shirley Clarke's Bridges Go Round, which presented two alternative soundtracks, one by the Barrons and another by jazz musician Teo Macero. The film's unique approach allowed viewers to witness how different soundtracks could greatly influence their perception of the same four-minute film depicting New York City bridges. However, the Barrons' most significant achievement came in 1956 when they composed the first-ever electronic score for a commercial film. This groundbreaking accomplishment was for the movie Forbidden Planet, produced by Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer. The Barrons seized the opportunity when they approached Dor Shari, who happened to be attending an exhibit of his wife's paintings. Impressed by their talent, Shari hired them to work on the film during its post-production phase.
Do you want to explore more composers? Who do you want to see featured next? Subscribe and leave a comment below to let me know. I'll see you in the next video.